All right, hello everyone and welcome back to my Fallout 4 Mod Spotlight series, where today we are having a look at yet another wonderful mod, this time in the form of Conquest, which is being made by user Chesco. And what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is the ability for you to build your own campsite anywhere out in the world that you would desire. Now, we already have looked at two other mods in this series that add in this ability, but what sets this one apart, and quite frankly, makes it oh so much better, is the fact that these campsites that we can build actually use the workshop mode rather than just throwing a grenade to spawn an item or have it placed in front of you. We can actually place it with delicacy and care in the workshop mode, and that is freaking great. But it gets even better. If you love your campsite that you've built so much that you'd like to make it a permanent residence for yourself, you can actually turn your campsite into a real settlement. Yes, that's right, folks. We can build our own custom settlements out in the world, and that is just amazing, and thankfully pretty easy to do. So let us take a gander at how this all works. And if we just go into the Pip-Boy and over into the inventory tab and then aid, we will have a new action here called build campsite. And if we select this, we'll be prompted right there to exit the Pip-Boy. And now we can place our campsite in the world. Now you'll notice we have a duffel bag outline on the ground, which is currently red. And if we hit E to place, you'll notice that it's telling us we cannot set up a camp here because we are too close to a city, another campsite, or another settlement. So we can either cancel placement and just go about our merry way doing whatever we want to, or we can hit back and continue to try and find a place to build this. Now, I've selected the airport here because I know if I turn around and just go right over here, you'll notice that the duffel bag is now green and we can place our campsite. So we can either, once we hit E, we can place our campsite here, once again, cancel placement and go about our merry way, or hit back and, you know, fine tune exactly where we want to place this, as this will be the center point of our camp. And if we just want to actually build our camp, there we go, place here, and you'll notice we're now in workshop mode. And that is wonderful. So in camping, we have a variety of things we can do. The first and foremost, of course, being an actual campfire, which we can place. Now, it really doesn't do anything besides, you know, provide light and look cool because, well, it's a campfire and it will use two wood. Next, we have furniture, where we have a good few options, actually. The first being a chair, so we can just sit down and have a little rest using two steel. We then have a sleeping bag requiring three cloth for us to sleep in. And then we have three separate tents, the first of which requiring plastic and only two of said plastic to build. And then we have two different cloth tents, this one personally being my favorite. I don't know, I just something about it I quite enjoy. There we go, we have a lovely tent over our campsite now, and that is just wonderful. Now the next category we have is in crafting, and the only option we have here at the moment is the cooking station, which you can build anywhere you like, but personally, I like placing it by the fire because, well, it just looks nicer. Now the next thing we can do is actually put in electrical power. Now we don't have many options here. We have a small portable generator, which requires two steel, one copper, one gear, and one rubber, and will only produce two electric charge. But the only thing we can then build to actually power are these construction lights, requiring one electrical charge each, and of course two steel and one glass. So this is quite useful if you want to add a spotlight to watch out for enemies in the night. But personally, since it's a campsite mod, I prefer using, in the camping miscellaneous section, just some lovely little oil lanterns using one glass, one steel, and one oil. You can place them around, they'll produce a little bit of light, and you're good to go. And it's just wonderful. We can close this now and of course hold down V to go back into the workshop mode, or we can also alternatively go to the camping supplies bag, which is essentially like the workshop bench. We can go and hit E to use it, and we can go into the workshop mode from here to set up our camp, or go to open bag, which will open up the inventory so we can transfer things in and out. We can also tear down the camp, which is actually quite interesting. Actually, if we hit back here real quick, all of these things right now that we have built that are in this camp right now, normally if we wanted to tear this down, you'd think we'd have to actually go to each and hit, say, perhaps scrap. Or, of course, we can hit tab on them and store them. But if you don't want to go to all that effort, you can just tear down the camp with a one simple quick little action. And we do that, everything disappears. And what's fun is it's all been stored in the camping workshop mode, which is awesome. So if we want to build another campsite, say we've torn down that camp for the night, and now it's the next day, we want to build a new campsite, we move to our new location, drop down our camping supplies duffel bag, place here, and you'll notice that in these different categories, we already have a campsite, so we don't have to spend more wood to build this campfire. We just place it because it's already there. And same thing with our chair. We have one chair, one sleeping bag, and one tent right there. We also have the one cooking pot, which of course, I didn't mention earlier, is a functioning cooking pot. You can use this for any cooking things, like a normal cooking station. And of course, we have our two different oil lamps, which is just wonderful. You don't have to take all that time to slowly break down your encampment. You can do it all in one fell swoop. And that just makes me happy. But what if you've built a glorious camp? Ooh, actually, before I do this next step, there's one more thing I probably should show you. With the campsites, they're not visible on the map. I should point that out right now because it's kind of a pet peeve of mine. I wish that it would show the campsite on the map, but sadly, no, it doesn't. So you'll just have to remember where your campsite is. But that being said, and now segueing to what I was about to say, what if you love your campsite? You've built it up nicely and you've enjoyed it and you want to make it a permanent, real, actual, factual settlement. Well, you just need to go back into the workshop mode and go to the camping expansion section. And in here, you have one option, and that is to build a workshop bench. And once this workshop bench is built, this campsite will be a real settlement in the world with a map marker that you can fast travel to. Now you'll notice up at the top though, we do have some things. So if we create a new settlement, it will be built here and the settlement will be centered on this workshop location. So that is going to be something important. It's just going to create a radius around this workshop bench to give you your workable area. So right now, if we built this, you probably wouldn't be building in the water over there. I mean, you could, but it'd be difficult. So it'll center it on this workshop bench. And the next part you can see there is we can only have 10 new custom settlements. And that, I think, is a good thing. So you can't just cover the wasteland in a whole huge number of settlements, whatever you care for. It is just a limit of 10, so you kind of got to strategically place them. And plus, I mean, it helps to not, you know, make your map too crazy full of waypoints. Though one thing I do kind of complain about that 10, part of the reason it has 10 is because you're not allowed to custom name your settlements. If we actually do build our settlement here, we will fade to black and then come back with a nice new UI dialog box, which allows us to select the name of our outpost. And the reason we can only have 10 different settlements is there are 10 names, or at least part of the reason. And these 10 names, I did actually find this quite interesting. The mod maker chose those names as the last names of several of the quality assurance engineers for Fallout 4, which I kind of find both amusing and a little bit disturbing, because who knows, your settlement might be a little bit more buggy than you hope for, because, well, obviously the quality assurance folks don't do their job. But yes, we can choose any of these 10 names and build our settlement. Now we have here the Caldera Dun Outpost, the Leon Outpost, Ferrani Outpost, we can hit next, and we have Garwood Outpost, Kreatz Outpost, Noland Outpost. And then we're back to the first page, and those are our options. So let us just go and pick one of these, and then be on our merry way for building our own custom workshop. So I think a good one to select is just Lyon, well, mainly because I love that city in France. It's one of my favorites to go to. And there we go, we have now discovered Lyon Outpost, which if we actually go to our Pip-Boy, we now have an actual marker for here. And that is just so wonderful. Oh my god, we have our own custom outpost now. One bad part though about the custom outpost. Remember all those things we built for our campsite? Yeah, they're gone. Now, they have been packed up, so next time we go and build a new campsite, they have been picked back up, so we will have that campfire and cooking pot that we laid down. But yes, those all disappeared, so if you liked the look of that tent and campfire you built, well, they're going to be gone. But in its place, you now have an actual workshop. Now, it works the same as with the duffel bag we set down. We can go up here and hit E on it to actually select the workshop mode, which then we have access to all of our typical workshop building aids, which is good. We can also hit E to activate and go to transfer, where we can move different items into here to provide resources, which is always nice. And then finally, we can actually dissolve a settlement. Now, if you do this, anything you build here will be lost. So don't just go on a whim and accidentally dissolve your settlement. That would be bad. So, because you don't want to lose all the wonderful things that you have built. So keep in mind for that, that would be a bad, bad thing to do. But if you do want to get rid of a settlement because you just don't like it anymore, you in fact can do that. Now, if you want to actually bring settlers here, you can. If you want to attach trade posts, you can. Everything you can do with a normal settlement, you can now also do with this. There really are no limitations. The only oddity is when you go to interact with this workshop mode, rather than the typical interactions in other settlements, you get this UI option, but that's really it. Other than that, we can do anything here. We can do at other settlements, build ourselves a nice workshop bench or a robot workbench, rather, our various structures, furniture, decorations, anything and everything that we want to do, we can do. The only oddities to that is, well, one, remember what I said, the workshop is limited to a radius around this workshop bench. So, as you can see the green outline there, that is our radius that we have, which is kind of glitching out a little bit there. It should be going a bit further into the water, and I, in fact, do think it is. I think we're just getting some weird visual glitch there. As you can see, when I look over to the right, we actually lose a bit of the left workshop highlighting. So, yes, I think that's just a visual glitch. But, yes, that is roughly the radius area that we have to deal with, and that's what your settlers are going to have to deal with to come here. So if you build it in a weird, inaccessible area, your settlers probably aren't going to be able to get to the workshop. So make sure you build it in a nice, accessible area so your settlers can get there, and an area that you can have plenty of room to work with. But yes, this is the Conquer mod once again, or Conquest mod, not Conquer, Conquest, yes. Once again, made by user Chesco, and it's amazing. You can build campsites, tear them down, move them to another location, or build from that campsite a true settlement. And that just makes me happy. And hopefully you have enjoyed it as well today. If you would like to try out this mod for yourself, you can take a look at the link in the description, as always. But I do, of course, hope you have enjoyed the episode and that you do come back for the next. But until then, thank you for watching. And as always, have a good one.